All right, so my name is Mario Torrero, and I'm actually the head of the National Center in Panama, which is in the Drug Regulatory Authority. And well, I've been there for around 2 years, approximately. Well, the first thing I must say is that pharmacovigilance in Panama is something that is very important, right? It's very important, but there are many things to do. But there are so many people, so many healthcare professionals, patients that needs to be aware of the importance of the pharmacovigilance. And actually, most of the importance of the pharmacovigilance is actually what we can do with it, with the reports they made. And basically, that's actually what we are starting to do. So making all the professionals more aware of why it is important. Yeah, basically the healthcare professionals may become a barrier, but actually they are very helpful because they are the ones who are reporting more than the patients. Actually, we have it included in our system, and they are reporting to us, the patients. I'm referring to the patients. They're reporting to us, but it's just, like less than 1% of the whole total reports that we got in the center. But I would say also that if that among the healthcare professionals in Panama, there is more participation of the pharmacists than the physicians and also than the nurses. But they are actually trying to do their best. So we have identified, that those professionals that are helping us a lot and those that are not. So just, trying to work with them to see how it can be improved. Some other barriers that we have identified that probably is not letting us improve our pharmacovigilance system could be, well, we just said the professionals and the patient, and it is related with the notification itself. But that there are a lot of things to do with the trainings, with some workshops, the way we communicate information or safety information. So there are some communication barriers that might be actually that becomes one of the most important thing because, okay, we can do a lot with the information we receive, but if we are not able or have a good communication service, then it's like, all right, what you have done, nobody knows, and nobody, okay, some people hears about pharmacovigilance, but no, they're not quite sure, and of what is that center doing. Well, actually, our communication initiative starts with, dear healthcare letters, all right? And we actually put all that information in our website. But that is one way to communicate that information. So the other thing is that we have subscribed some healthcare professionals with their email. So we have them all, right? And we send all those letters to the email we have registered in our database. But it's like not that too much, but at least we are pretty sure that those emails that we have registered in our database are receiving the information. And one interesting thing is that when they notice that there is no communication coming in, they send us an email back saying, "Hey, is there something wrong with your email? That we, because we haven't received nothing this week, or everything is fine." So just to make sure that actually we are still working with the same communication ways. And that's pretty good, actually. And well, we do not use media at all, Facebook or things like that. But we are looking forward to see how the Ministry of Health can just, identify a way to use that tool also. Well, actually, since pharmacovigilance is part of the Drug Regulatory Authority, and the Drug Regulatory Authority part of the Ministry of Health, any situation that affects the health public and where a drug is, involved, yes, we are gonna be related, or we're gonna need to do something or investigate. And we had some cases where actually we have some healthcare professionals that were working in our national center that are actually part of an investigation process. It is something that seems, it is not very good understood how the pharmacovigilance work and what the national centers do. So then misinterpretation or misunderstandings of our job could be just, you know, made during all the process of the post-marketing of a drug. Well, I can tell you that in Panama, the pharmacovigilance considers three types of reports, which is the adverse drug reactions. We have the defect quality products and also the failure therapy. So since we do see the quality defects as one of the parts of the notifications, so there are some things that are coming in that might be related to counterfeit, but actually we are not sure of that. So we just have an idea of some quality defects issues that are coming in. So we just, you know, try to investigate and see how it is affecting to our population, and just recommend, you know, some decisions and actions that might be helping to prevent some other issues. Actually, the notifications are also saying that there is a problem, but that may become worse because there are many people using that product. So it's just something really good because not many national centers are used to work with defect quality products at all. It's part of any other instance in the minister or in the drug regulatory authority. Well, I do think that the future of pharmacovigilance in Panama is quite good if we keep following all those goals that we have established at the moment. There are many things to learn, and I'm pretty sure that actually our authorities are quite sure that there is a change that needs to be made, and that a lot of things that we have to do to improve our system, and that it's not something about the National Center, it's just about everybody.